take a step back. Cause it's Elie Seckbach. Remember yesterday? Adrian Broner is the most focused Broner I've ever seen. He's on weight already, has a six pack.
Are you making it up or?
No, no, he has a six pack. I can show you the videos. Big G, Broner is in very good shape. What do you think? Him and Pacquiao.
Who's that?
Broner.
The Broner va a pelear pues con Pacquiao. ¿Qué piensa?
Yo pienso que Pacquiao lo va a ganar.
I don't think Pacquiao is going to win.
Why?
¿Por qué, pa?
Pues, y mucha experiencia y es mucho mejor que.
He's got a lot of experience and he's a lot better.
Muchísimo mejor.
He just turned 40 this week, Pacquiao.
¿Cómo?
What was that?
He just turned 40 yesterday.
Yeah, cumplió 40, Pacquiao.
Ah, pues esa es una desventaja ya para él también.
It's a disadvantage for Pacquiao.
Por eso pensamos que hasta le pudiéramos ganar con una pelea con Mike, por la edad también. Pero no porque no es bueno.
Oh, he's really good, man. That's, just, that's probably an advantage that the fighters have. That's what we think. Maybe Mikey would be able to beat him because of the age, but not because he's not a good fighter. He's a hell of a fighter.
So if Broner wins, what does that say?
Si gana Broner, ¿qué quiere decir?
Because a lot of people are doubting.
¿Que ya se acabó?
Oh, sí. Si ya gana Broner, es razonable que vamos a... Todo el mundo va a decir que se acabó Pacquiao.
Sí. If Broner wins, si no, nunca everybody's going to know and realize that Pacquiao's done.
What about Teofimo Lopez, Ryan Garcia? They're in the same weight class.
Oh,
they almost have the same record. Ryan has eight more fights than him.
Yeah, but Teofimo's much better. Teofimo's more, like, as a fighter, popularity, I think probably Ryan, but I think Teofimo's just much better to fight. I think Teofimo beats him.
What about Rolly?
I think Teofimo's ready to fight the maybe world-class fighters.
Like Lomachenko.
Believe me, I think Teofimo will not now, maybe not the next fight, but 3-4 fights from now, I think Teofimo gives Lomachenko all he could handle. I really believe so.
That's a big statement.
Yeah, Teofimo Lopez. I think he will. Three fights from now.
He's fighting again in February.
Well, by the end of the year, I think he might be a good challenge for Loma. I'm not saying he beats him, but I think it's going to be a really good challenge. And he might even beat him. I think so.
Big G, do you know Teofimo?
No, I don't think so. Usted no conoce a Teofimo López, ¿eh? Teofimo López. No, he doesn't.
Not yet. What about Mikey 135 against Ryan Garcia 135?
Fucking
hell.
¿Con quién? Elie, what the fuck? Con el Garcia, con el Ryan Garcia, bro. Este güey ya la cagó, ¿eh?
Give me the same face you did.
Come on, Elie.
What do you mean? Okay.
Él tiene mucha experiencia para entrevistar personas de él que no comete errores.
You have a lot of experience in interviewing people. Don't make those mistakes.
Okay, what about... Okay, let's talk about this.
Es un error.
March 16, Mikey Garcia Spence. What do you think? Mikey is starting to train now slowly?
Little by little.
Yeah?
Apa, Mike. ¿Cómo está, Mike?
What does he think about the fight, Mikey Spence?
Pero le vamos a ganar.
We're gonna win the fight, but I'm telling Mike he hasn't even trained yet.
Nadie le puede ganar con por fuerte que esté a alguien que tenga tanto talento.
Yeah, my dad says, for as strong as he could be, the talent that Mikey has, it's probably gonna
siempre el talento. Por eso siempre está la frase que yo he dicho, es mejor ser vivo que ser valiente.
What's that?
My dad says he always has a phrase saying it's better to be smart than to be.
You bold. Know who always tells me that? Fernando Vargas. He always quotes you that. Yeah. Fernando tells me that. How about this? Josecito Lopez, Keith Thurman. Keith Thurman undefeated, a champion. What do you think?
Yo espero que ganemos la pelea por el otro tiene mucho que no pelea y si no estuvo entrenando porque estaba jodido la mano. Yo creo que tenemos muy buena chance.
Said we have a very great chance of winning the fight because Broner's been out for
Thurman.
A
while. Thurman.
Oh yeah, my bad. Thurman's been out for a while, and my dad says, and I don't think he was in the gym because he was injured. So that means he wasn't sparring or anything like that. So we have that advantage.
Puede quisiera alguien una pregunta que por qué Mike no se le echó de ver, pero Mike nunca paró de entrenar.
Yeah, like my dad says, they could ask the same thing about Mikey. Mikey was out for 2.5 years, but Mikey was always training and sparring. He never stopped coming to the
gym. But Thurman was injured. It's different when you have an injury.
Yeah, Thurman was injured. So that doesn't mean Thurman was sparring. He couldn't be sparring because he was injured. Mikey was always sparring.
He was sparring Maidana.
Yeah, Mikey was always sparring throughout those 2.5 years. Yeah.
Okay, I got to ask you this. Abner Mars, Gervonta Davis. Very, very tough fight. Not an easy fight.
Who?
Gervonta and Abner. Well, Abner is moving up to 130.
Yeah,
Tank has 19 knockouts.
It's also a big challenge. Look, Abner's got the experience, already three division champion, yeah. But it's a very tough fight. We all know that, but so is Mikey's fight against Darrell. They're very tough fights, but to be great,
Abner
wants to take that chance. He wants to be great, becoming a four division champion. Why not? Why not give it a shot? You know what I mean? It's just,
by the way,
fighters are great champions do that.
Abner has a very nice show on Fox. It's him, Sean Porter, and his girl. Have you watched it?
Yeah, I've been watching that shit.
The one guy they have as the boxing expert is horrible.
Yeah,
he stutters, he's nervous. Abner's good.
Yeah,
Porter's good. Porter's good. The girl Kate is good, but the one guy they have as the insider,
I don't even know.
He sucks.
But
he's nervous. He shakes on the camera.
But Abner was hired. Abner was bringing for Telemundo too.
Yes, he was.
In Spanish. And he does as good
English.
English.
He's very talented.
Abner's got one of those. He could do that for many years. If he retires from boxing, he could continue doing that, like, just like Paulie is right now.
Abner is one of the nicest people in boxing.
¿Has aprendido la lista del agua?
Big G, did you know that Abner does broadcasting in Spanish and English?
Abner es comentarista y hace en español y en inglés. Y lo hace muy bien. Sí, es muy bueno para eso. Tiene una carrera en eso si él quiere después.
Bueno, porque ya su carrera de él como boxeador yo creo que está terminando.
Estamos en las últimas.
Está en las últimas ya. Y también muchas veces cuando estamos.
You're out, Louis.
Yeah.
All right, we'll see. I'll stop by.
Como él, que tú lo tienes.
That was a good sandwich. Okay. Could tell your wife we were impressed.
No,
pues es porque tiene el ánimo de ir a ganar su cuarta división. Tenemos que seguir, así es. La manera de hacer es, look, with Abner, my dad is great that he's doing the commentary thing, you know, because we also know that in boxing.
You need a career, yes?
Maybe he's really looking, you know, towards the last few fights of his career, because, you know, we got to be real. You know, that's the way boxing is.
Yeah.
You can't box for the rest of your life. So it's great that he's doing things like that, and he's really good at it. You know, he's really good at it. He is.
That's true. He's a natural. It's not easy to be in front of a camera, Robert. A lot of people freeze. You've done it with BKB. You've done broadcasting.
And you know, I've done it, but I don't think I'm, you know.
People gave you compliments.
Yeah, but like Abner.
But it takes years of experience, unless there are naturals.
You know, a good thing about Abner is that he could do it for Telemundo, and then he could do it for Fox.
Well,
you know, he could do
both. I'm gonna tell you something interesting.
Spanish and English.
HBO never had a Spanish-speaking broadcaster. They were all white or African American. Black, but they could never translate what a trainer says in the corner. They had to go to some guy with glasses who doesn't even speak Spanish.
No idea.
He was horrible.
Yeah, he was bad.
So I always said you need to hire someone like Chris Arreola, like Brandon doesn't speak Spanish, but maybe like the Big G would work. He would keep it 100.
Yeah, but I also think you need the English to translate.
So you could have done it. Abner could do it now, but no more HBO. I think they need to hire, like, Raul Marquez speaks English and Spanish.
Raul Marquez is really good, too.
So,
and he already has a lot of experience.
That's true. So it always helps when a broadcaster can understand what the fighter's saying and not listen to some guy that doesn't even speak. Why did they use him?
Yeah, that says things that the fighter never
They made
said.
Up.
Yeah.
Even the Russian translator would do that with Provodnikov, just make up shit.
Oh, yeah? Well, nobody knows what they're saying anyway, so.
That's it.
Fuck it.
But it is what it is. So, right now, you're waiting. I think the official announcement about Mars' fight, the location, will be out today or tomorrow.
Is that right?
With all the details, yeah. Josecito's in camp. He's training next, right?
Yeah, he's right. He's coming at 2.
So, Big G, are you going to be in the corner, or you have another fight card that weekend in Texas?
We're going to be in that quinceañera, remember?
Oh, you're going to be a quinceañera. And that's the only date you told him, don't book for me.
Well, through Mikey and Abner, but then it happens to be that Josecito gets that shot.
Why not put him on the same card as Abner?
Or
put him
on
the same.
There was no option. Either you take it or they give it to somebody else.
So you took it.
We took it. We're gonna train him.
So Josecito is extra motivated.
Quería hasta irme desde que se vaya Josecito y Pita.
Pero no puede, pues. Pues nos vamos a quedar. ¿A la quinceañera?
Oh, de veras.
Sí.
Someone said here change the quinceañera date. You can't change a birthday.
It's not, we could have changed that, but look.
The DJ,
everything's already
the guests.
You know, the music, the food.
It's a big event.
Booked.
Yeah.
The place, the hall, the place where we're going to have it, it's already booked. So, and we couldn't pick any other days because the whole year is booked already.
That's true.
So we can't.